The uncertainty principle. The success of scientific theories, particularly Newton's theory of gravity, led the French scientist, the Marquis de Laplace, at the beginning of the 19th century, to argue that the universe was completely deterministic. Laplace suggested that there should be a set of scientific laws that would allow us to predict everything that would happen in the universe, if only we knew the complete state of the universe at one time. For example, if we knew the positions and speeds of the sun and the planets at one time, then we could use Newton's laws to calculate the state of the solar system at any other time. Determinism seems fairly obvious in this case, but Laplace went further to assume that there were similar laws governing everything else, including human behavior. The doctrine of scientific determinism was strongly resisted by many people who felt that it infringed God's freedom to intervene in the world, but it remained the standard assumption of science until the early years of this century. One of the first indications that this belief would have to be abandoned came when calculations by the British scientists Lord Rayleigh and Sir James Deans suggested that a hot object or body such as a star must radiate energy at an infinite rate. According to the laws we believed at the time, a hot body ought to give off electromagnetic waves such as radio waves, visible light, or X-rays equally at all frequencies. For example, a hot body should radiate the same amount of energy and waves with frequencies between 1 and 2 million waves a second, as in waves with frequencies between 2 and 3 million waves a second. Now, since the number of waves a second is unlimited, this would mean that the total energy radiated would be infinite. In order to avoid this obviously ridiculous result, the German scientist Max Planck suggested in 1900 that light, X-rays, and other waves could not be emitted at an arbitrary rate, but only in certain packets that he called quanta. Moreover, each quantum had a certain amount of energy that was greater or higher the frequency of the waves. So at a higher enough frequency, the emission of a single quantum would require more energy than was available. Thus, the radiation at high frequencies would be reduced, and so the rate at which the body lost energy would be finite. The quantum hypothesis explained the observed rate of emission of radiation from hot bodies very well, but its implications for determinism were not realized until 1926, when another German scientist, Werner Heisenberg, formulated his famous uncertainty principle. In order to predict the future position and velocity of a particle, one has to be able to measure its present position and velocity accurately. The obvious way to do this is to shine light on the particle. Some of the waves of light will be scattered by the particle, and this will indicate its position. However, one will not be able to determine the position of the particle more accurately than the distance between the wave crests of light. So one needs to use light of a short wavelength in order to measure the position of the particle precisely. Now, by Planck's quantum hypothesis, one cannot use an arbitrarily small amount of light. One has to use at least one quantum. This quantum will disturb the particle and change its velocity in a way that cannot be predicted. Moreover, the more accurately one measures the position, the shorter the wavelength of the light that one needs, and hence the higher the energy of the single quantum. So the velocity of the particle will be disturbed by a larger amount. In other words, the more accurately you try to measure the position of the particle, the less accurately you can measure its speed, and vice versa. Heisenberg showed that the uncertainty in the position of the particle times the uncertainty in its velocity times the mass of the particle can never be smaller than a certain quantity, which is known as Planck's constant. Moreover, this limit does not depend on the way in which one tries to measure the position or velocity of the particle, or on the type of particle. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is a fundamental, inescapable property of the world.
have some music, and that piece I created many years ago, and Anthony happened to see it in Baltimore.
Yes.
And so it was a request. And it goes on.
Wow.
But that's plenty for us. But I have another offering for you, so we can use it.